India has drawn the world's attention in recent years with its booming economic growth, large demographic of young English-speaking workers, and its shift from an agricultural to a more service-oriented economy. The human population is ever-growing. Hand in hand with this growing population, new human settlements have come up and industries have been set up to fulfill the basic needs. In the midst of all the economic development, we ignored an essential point of waste management. We can see waste all around us, outside our house, schools, slums, on roads, everywhere. We don't pay much attention because we feel it's not our job. Then whose job is it? The people who are allotted for this? Many of us will say yes, but I resent this action because every individual is a part of the solution of this global problem. What do you think the main reasons of the unmanaged waste could be? The answer is lack of awareness and of course people's careless reactions. How easy it is to throw the plastic bags and the leftovers everywhere but in the dustbin. Our river Gomti is so contaminated by the waste from our houses and industries that it's harmful for the health of human beings as well as animals who drink the water of river Gomti. Our river Gomti is not pure anymore now. Open dumping grounds in the city causes a lot of health issues. They contaminate the environment in the most harmful way. Unmanaged waste causes air pollution, which in all ways is a harm to the living body. Many incurable diseases are acquired by the human bodies because of the polluted air. Not only the air, but due to the decomposition of an organic waste, the groundwater is contaminated. The waste from the hospitals too are not being disposed of at the outskirts of the city. As my friend took a walk around our city, he couldn't help but notice the dumped waste on the roads outside PGI hospital. The dogs and cows were feeding on them, which is deadly injurious to health. Breathing in such a contaminated, foul-smelling air is a huge task in itself. Furthermore, covering the slum areas, we could see the pathetic conditions people living in. The scene is really pitiful. Seeing the drain water covering all of the place and the rate of garbage is beyond expectations. It was a fearful sight eyeing people actually living in these regions. The insight on the conditions of our city was really unappalling. Working on the policy of it's never too late, our Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi launched the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan to make India a clean country. It aims at teaching citizens to reduce and even clean their own waste. This step was a huge motivation to the youth of today. We could see much cleaner places now than before. This Abhiyan ignited the youth of today and every individual contributed in his own way. But there is a lot yet needed to be done. Various plans were established by the governments and industrialists were guided not to throw the waste into the river. The government is doing a lot in these issues, but then it's the people whose ignorant behavior is countering it. There are various policies set up by the government too, and just to make people aware, the government has put signboards of Clean India and Green India and many more. But it shouldn't just be the central and the state government working at their levels, it should be every individual working at their own level that will sum up and contribute as a whole environment. If we will pull in together and join our hands for taking an initiative in making this world a better place, then this sure will be a success. We work at our level and government at there. Then I don't think anybody can stop India from being cleaner and greener. After all, nothing is impossible. It's little steps that count. And just remember, be the change you want to.